Hi, this is Ashok Kelshala, Assistant Professor of Chemistry from Kakatiya Government College, Hanumkonda, Warangal, Urban District, Telangana State, India. Today, we will going to discuss about conformational isomerism, conformational analysis and conformational isomerism. In the previous sessions, we are discussing about the stereoisomerism, where in the stereoisomerism we discussed about what is geometrical or suspense isomerism and what is the optical isomerism and how the optical isomers are represented in different formulas like wedge dash method, Newman projection and Fisher projection and Sauer's formulas. In this session we discuss about the stereoisomerism. In stereoisomerism, the topic is conformational isomerism and conformation analysis. In this, we will going to discuss about what I meant to say, a conformation analysis first part. And in this first and second part, we're discussing, in first part, we'll discuss mainly focused on methane, ethane, butane, and another one is 1,2 dichloroethane, another one is the 2-chloroethanol. And in the next conformation analysis 2, we are going to discuss about the conformations of cyclohexane and what is Bayer's triethane. And in this, we are going to discuss about the stereo, that is conformational isomerism of what? The methane or what, of course, how does it is methane does not form or anything. Mainly, we discuss focused on the ethane and another one is said to be the butane, 1,2 dichloroethane and 2-chloroethanol. Let us see, first before going to this conformation analysis, let us discuss some basic points regarding the stereoisomers or isomerism. The classification of stereoisomers are normal isomers based on energy. Let us see, this is going to be the classification of this one. What is this? You see, these actually the isomers are first classified into constitutional isomers and another one is said to be the stereoisomers. And these constitutional isomers we discussed in the structural isomerism, where this is due to the concept that is attaching the bonds in the different way, like structural isomerism. In structural isomerism, we discussed about what is chain isomerism, positional isomerism, and what is functional isomerism, metamerism, and what is tautomerism, etc., considered under constitutional isomerism. And this was discussed while in our discussion in the isomerism topic. And now come to the other isomers, what are the stereoisomers? That is now our topic, this one. And these stereoisomers again classified into configurational and conformational. And configurational again classified into the geometrical isomers, that is cis trans. This is going to be the trans isomer. This is going to be the cis isomer. That cis trans isomers are said to be the geometrical isomers. And in another way, in optical isomers, we discussed in configurational, we discussed about the optical isomers, where we discussed in the optical isomerism while discussing in the previous sessions. What are the enantiomers and what are the diastereomers? Enantiomers are the non-superimposable mirror images, which are another way called dextro and levo rotatory. And diastereomers are said to be they are not mirror images and not superimposable, are called diastereomers. And all these things, what I mean to say, constitutional isomers and configurational isomers in these geometric isomers, what are optical isomers, what are enantiomers, and what are diastereomers? We all discussed in the previous sessions. You can check it and you can watch those things. Now, in this session, the other one is said to be the conformational isomerism. And this is going to be the conformational isomerism, and this is going to be a butane isomer. And what is this conformational isomer? What type of the bond, what type of the structures can be shown in the conformational isomers? Let us discuss one by one. Let us see what is meant by a constitutional isomer. Isomers that differ in connectivity are called constitutional or sometimes structural isomers. They have the same parts they have the same pods, but those pods are attached to each other differently. The bracelets of red and green beads mentioned above are analogous to constitutional isomers. The simplest hydrocarbons, methane, ethane, and propane, have no constitutional isomers because this is a 2-carbon, this is a 3-carbon. And as there is no other way to connect the carbons and hydrogens of these molecules, consistent with the tetravalency of the carbon and the univalency of hydrogen. See, this is the methane. There is no other connectivity. There is no other connectivity. They do not possess any isomerisms. And that is what I meant to say in constitutional isomerisms. However, there are two different butane, C4H10, and these two molecules called butane and isobutane, and they are said to be the constitutional isomers. They are different molecules with a different chemical and physical properties. Butane has its 4 carbon atoms bonded in a continuous chain or in a branched chain like in isobutane. You can see the structure. This is a straight chain. This is going to be a straight chain or a chain isomers. Or these are two are said to be chain isomers. It is going to be the a branched one. It is a straight chain. It is normal butane, whereas it is isobutane. That means if you see the isomerism, that is constitutional isomerism, it is observed from starting from the N-butane, that is butane only, not up to the propane. Now let us see what are the conformational isomers, that is our topic. Methane is a molecule that is a perfect tetrahedron, and so it is commonly said to that no isomerism is possible with methane. However, the carbon hydrogen bonds of methane constantly vibrate and bend so that on a very short time scales an apparent isomerism can be said to exist, but these structures are not energy minima and so they do not qualify as isomers. See, this is going to be the tetrahedron structure of the, what I meant to say, the methane. The bond angle is 109.5 degrees, and you can see this is going to be the three-dimensional structure. This is going to be the, you can understood, this is going to be the wedge dash method and wedge dash formula. This is going to be the towards observer. This is going to be the away from the observer. As complexity increases, isomerism induced by rotations about bonds becomes a bigger factor. In ethane, for example, both carbons are approximately tetrahedral. Thus, there are two limiting structures. One is said to be the staggered ethane, in which the carbon-hydrogen bonds are as far apart as possible. And another one is said to be the eclipsed ethane, in which the bonds are as close as possible. That means staggered one is the bonds as far as apart as possible, whereas in a eclipsed form, the bonds are as close as possible. And in the staggered form, as far as apart. These two structures are certainly not the same. Perhaps the best view in which to see the difference is a Newman projection, named after American chemist Melvin Newman, in which one sides down the carbon-carbon bond and focuses on the positions of the 6 hydrogens. In Newman projection, the front carbon is located at the intersection of the bonds to the 3 attached hydrogen atoms, and the back carbon is in a exploded as a circle with attached bonds emanating from the circumference of the circle. Means the front carbon is represented with a dot and the back carbon is represented with a circle. The remaining 3 bonds will be what I mean seminated, and you can see this one. See, this is going to be the staggered ethane, where this is a wedge dash formula method, and here it is going to be the Newman projection formula, where this the circle is said to be the back carbon, and here this specific dot, and I can show you in the, see, you can see this is going to be the, what I meant to say, this is going to be the front carbon where it is indicated with the dot, whereas this is indicated is going to be the, what I mean to say, the back carbon. So that in Newman projection format is indicated. The remaining bonds will be, see, they are indicated with these lines, normal lines. In a, just now I told you in the staggered case, the bonds are as part as away from the each other. Whereas you see in the eclipsed ethane, the bonds are as close as possible. Here actually it is not mentioned, the hydrogen is almost here, the bond angle is almost 0 degrees. Whereas here the bond angle is maximum that is possible in this case. Now let us see the other one. Conformation analysis. Conformation analysis is a pioneer of Hassel, Norway and H.R. Borten, and both were awarded Nobel Prize for their conformational analysis. Conformation means what? Means the different arrangement of atoms in space that result from rotations of groups about a single bond. That means different arrangement of atoms in space that results from rotations of groups about a single bond. Conformation analysis, an analysis of the energy changes that occur as a molecule undergoes rotation about the single bond. You can see what is the difference between a conformation and conformation. This is with respect to the energy change, and this is with respect to the arrangement of atoms in space by rotation, they will be changed. The different the different 3D arrangements in space of the atoms in a molecule. See, the two different 3D arrangements in space of the atoms in a molecule are not interconvertible. They are called configurations. Configuration represent isomers that can be separated. If 3D arrangements in space of the atoms in a molecule are interconvertible merely by carbon-carbon free rotation, are called as, that is, they are called as conformation. Conformation represent conformers which are rapidly interconvertible and non-separatable. Each possible structure is called as conformer or rotamer. You remember that the conformations in other ways also called rotamer, means they are found by the rotation about carbon-carbon single bond. This is going to be the carbon-carbon, this is going to be the single bond. By rotating it, you can observe that this goes to this and this goes to like this. This will be the rotation. The angle of torsion, dihedral angle, between the carbon, that is X, C and C. This is going to be X, C and C. And other one is the C, C, Y plane. This is going to be C, C and Y planes. And here in the Newman projection formula, you can see that this is staggered conformation, and the carbon is, the front carbon is denoted with the dot, here it is the dot, and the rear carbon is shown by a circle. And in the staggered, I told you that the bond angle is maximum, that is going to be the 60 degrees between the two bonds in the case of the ethane. Let us see what are the different conformations. And what are the different forms? Gauche, in another one is said to be the staggered form. This is a low energy conformation where the bonds on adjacent atom bisects each other. Just now we observed that it is a 60 degrees dihedral angle and maximizing the separation. There is a maximum separation. And this is going to be, you can observe, this is going to be the Gauche form or a staggered form. And you can see the maximum bond angle is present in this case, and maximum, that is minimum repulsions between these atoms or groups when they are present on these atoms. Eclipsed form, a high energy conformation where the bonds on adjacent atoms are aligned with each other. That means the dihedral angle is almost zero. And here you can observe the structure. This is the bond angle is zero. And here all groups and then going to be very close to each other, and there is a maximum repetition. Among the staggered and eclipsed form, generally the staggered forms are more stable than the eclipsed form. That is least stable or eclipsed form, and that is high stable or general. And sometimes there is some differences also, but in general, the staggered forms are stable forms and eclipsed forms are least stable. Then what is an antiform? Description given to two substituents attached to adjacent atoms when their bonds are about 180 degrees with respect to each other. Let us see this one. If you observe, this is a butane. This is going to be the butane. And here, this antiform is with respect to two methyl groups. They are away from the, their bond angle is going to be the 180 degrees when the two similar groups are in opposite. That is, in their bond angle is their angle, the dihedral bond angle is going to be the 180 degrees, and such a form is said to be the antiform. Let us see what is syn-form. Description given to two substituents attached to adjacent atoms when their bonds are 0 degrees with respect to each other. See, this is going to be the syn-form, and this is another way we can say this is similar to the staggered one, this is similar to the what I meant to say, eclipse one. But with respect to the two groups, when you say, in another way we call it as the antiform, this is called as a what? It is going to be called as syn-form. Then what are the types of strains present in the conformers? First one is said to be the steric strain. The potential energy arises due to the repulsion between the electron clouds of atoms and groups. Groups try to occupy some common space. You can see this is going to be the steric strain. And when groups occupy nearby, their electron clouds will make repulsion on each other like this. And that type of strain is called steric strain. And other one is the torsional strain. This potential energy arises due to the repulsion between the pairs of bonds caused by the electrostatic repulsion of the electrons of the bonds. Groups are eclipsed. Let us see this. And here this is due to the, this what I meant to say, repulsion between these bonded electron pairs. Now let us see some structures in the Newman projection and a Sauer structure. And you know this is a 0 degrees, bond angle is 0 degrees. Therefore you can say it is a eclipsed conformation. Another one, you see, there is a 60 degrees bond angle, and therefore there is a maximum bond angle that can be possible between the two bonds in the case of the ethane. And this is going to be a 60 degrees, and this for me, this is called as a staggered form. Now let us see, this is going to be again 0 degree here theta is anything else that is between the 0 degrees to 60 degrees. 1 degree, 2 degree, 10 degree, 20 degree, or anything else, and that remaining forms are called as the skew forms. They are called skew forms. Similarly, you can say this is going to be the eclipsed form in Sauer structure. See, this is going to be the that is coincide with each other. This is going to be the coincide with each other. And see, here this is above the plane, this is going to be below the plane, this side and this side, and like this. That's why it is the staggered forms are shown in the Sauer structure in this way. And this is going to the skew form, and that is they are all in different directions. And that means the bond angle is between 0 to 60 degrees is said to be the skew forms. Now let us see the other one. That 60 degree rotation causes torsional or eclipsing strain. This is going to be the 60 degrees bond angle. And rotation about the 60 degrees always gives the staggered conformation. Then rotate around the carbon. This is the carbon-carbon single bond about 60 degrees centigrade. You will get again this one. Ethane eclipsed conformation, you can get this one. And higher, that is, here to here it is 60 degrees. Therefore, keep static this rear carbon and then simply rotate this one like this. And simply rotate this bond like this. This rotate this bond only front carbon towards this. Then what happens? You will get this one. See the hydrogen. This hydrogen comes to here so that you can get this one. And here there will be some energy because of the repulsion, the potential energy rises. And here 4 kilojoules, here 4 kilojoules of potential energy will be rises. In this way, the rotation or the when a staggered conformer, when a rotated between the carbon-carbon free rotation, you will get an eclipsed form. See the eclipsed conformers of ethane. You can see these are the eclipsed conformers of ethane, these two, because they are higher in energy. And you can observe this is going to be the, what I mean, the staggered conformers of ethane, which are lower in energy. You can observe. See, in this direction, it is increasing the potential energy. This is the bond angle. And if you observe, see, this is case is potential energy increasing, and this is going to be the, what you say, bond angles. See, this is about 0 degree bond angle. Here there is no, what I mean to say, there is no bond angle, that is 0 degree bond angle. That's why we can say it is an eclipsed one, higher in energy. Thereby rotating 0 to 60 degrees, then slowly the potential energy decreases and reaches the lowest when it is 60 degrees. Then again when you rotate like this, what happens? See, then it is again rotated. When 60 degrees to 120 degrees, what happens? Slowly again the potential energy increases and it reaches maximum at 120 degrees. And here this bond angle is again 0 degrees. That's why it is higher in energy. Again 180 degrees, from 120 to 180 degrees, again slowly the potential energy decreases and reaches the minimum at 180 degrees. Then again when you rotate like this, what happens? Again 180 to 240 degree rotation, then again the energy will be increases. And here it reaches the maximum to 240 and then again decreases to 300, then again increases to 360. And here the total energy difference, that is between the staggered conformer and eclipsed conformer, is around how much? 12 kilojoules of energy. The barriers of rotations are far too small to allow isolation of the different staggered conformations or conformers, even at temperatures considered below room temperature. This is going to be the staggered one. This is going to be the nearly eclipsed one. This is not possible to isolate. These conformers cannot be isolated except at extremely low temperature. Now let us see this one. I will show this. Another, I want to show you that the butane conformer. Here, this is going to be the ethane. See, this is going to be ethane conformation isomerism. And see, this is going to be the minus 180 degrees. See, this is going to be at minus 180 degrees. That is around, let us say, what I mean to say, it is a staggered conformation. Then while going here, up and up, see, when it goes here, the energy increases. Then it comes to here, this energy. In this way, you can observe that by rotating this one, what happens? You can say eclipsed one, staggered one. You can say whenever it is staggered one, it is going to be the lower in energy. Whenever it is going to be the staggered one, it is higher in energy. That you can observe. Now let us go for the another shape. Let us see, we are discussing this one. Now, See, these are the, now let us, till now we discussed about the conformational isomers of the ethane. Now the time is for the discussing the conformational isomers of the butane. And this is the different structure, different conformationals of this one. This is an antiform, we discussed already. What is the definition of the antiform? This is with respect to the two groups, when the bond angle between these two groups is the 180 degrees, that is called antiform. And this is going to be an eclipsed form or eclipsed conformation. And here by rotating 60 degrees, then you'll get this one. And by rotating another 60 degrees, you'll get this one. And by rotating one more 60 degrees, and you will get an eclipsed form. This is going to be the eclipse form. In another way, we can call it as the syn form. This is going to be the antiform or staggered form. This is going to be the syn form with respect to the two methyl groups. By rotating once again the 60 degrees, you will get a Gauche conformation, and again you will get an eclipse conformation. Let us see. Let us discuss this is about see, does not have a torsional strain. The figure one has any, what I mean to say, no torsional strain, and therefore it is more stable. If you see figure 3 and 5, this is going to be 3 and 5. These are similar. This just to be, this is B side, left side, this is right side. And 3 and 5, the two methyl groups are close enough to each other. The van der Waals forces of between them are repulsive. The torsional strain is around 3.8 kilojoules per mole. And in the case of second and fourth and sixth, the energy is maximum, because you see these are three or the eclipsed conformation. Among these three eclipsed conformation, what, which one is higher in energy or higher in repulsions? And this form, that is fourth form, second and fourth have torsional strain and van der Waals repulsion arising from the eclipsed methyl groups and hydrogen atoms. Sixth has the greatest energy due to the large van der Waals repulsion forces arising. This is not sixth one, this is going to be the fourth one, because the two methyl groups are, what I meant to say, they are close to each other and higher in energy. Now let us see this one. This is going to be the fourth form, not sixth one. By mistake it was formed. And different conformations of butane. Let us see. This is, you know, antiform, and it is lower in energy, almost zero in energy. And you can see this is going to be the another eclipsed form, where the methyl hydrogens are, methyl and hydrogens are eclipsed. And because of this, it is 6. And because of this two hydrogen, it is 4 kilojoules. Because of this strain, this is going to be 6. Totally 6 plus 4, 10. 10 plus 6, it is going to be the, what I mean to say, it is going to be the, that is 16 kilojoules of energy. When you come to the fourth form, that is fourth structure, the two methyl groups, you can see these two methyl groups. This is going to be the two methyl groups, you can observe here. This is the two methyl groups where they are close to each other, and eclipsed one, there is higher strain because the bulky groups when respect to the hydrogen. And that's why, because of the strain, there are 11 kilojoules of energy. And I told you between the hydrogen only 4, therefore it is 4 and 4. And you can see 4, then this is also 4, 4 plus 4, 8, 8 plus 11, 9, then it is 9. That means here the fourth form is going to be the 19 kilojoules, whereas sixth form is, this is going to be the, just now we discussed this, the sixth form, and this is going to be the fourth form in the above structure, and this is the higher in energy. This is about next to the fourth form, and finally the first form is this one. This is the first form, and this is going to be the least in energy, almost more stable in the case. Now let us go for the see, the energy barriers are still too small, permit isolation of the Gauche and anti-conformers at normal temperature. And this is going to be the, what I meant to say, what? Eclipsed form, 16 kilojoules of energy. And here, the fourth form, this is higher, that is 19 kilojoules of energy. and this is going to be again sixth form. And the second and the sixth, and these are both having the same 16 kilojoules of energy because the strain is same, the strain is or repulsions are same. And here this is, and you can see this is the Gache form. Here this is going to be the Gache form at 120 degrees. And here you'll get the antiform with a lower in energy at 0 degrees. And another is at 240 degrees, you'll get another Gache form. And finally, again, the antiform is there. See, the difference between these eclipsed forms, between this and that means this fourth form and the second and sixth form is going to be 3.8 kilojoules. This is going to be here. Here, this is the difference. Now let us see this one. I will share you this. And see, this is the case. This is in the case of the butane, how the energy will be changed. And see, this is how does it will be changed. Again, once again, you can see, observe it. What happens here? This is going to be the eclipsed form. This is the second form and this is the sixth form. This is going to be the fourth. And so that you can have the maximum energy, you can see that is, see, this is going to be the, see, this is going to be here, one more carbon is not shown, this is the dotted line, and that's why you are not observing here. You can observe the, how does the energy will be changed. And this is going to be the highest in energy, where we discussed it till now, that is going to be the fourth form. And this is going to be the second and fourth. And here it is going to be the antiform, and here it is going to be the antiform, where their energy is very, very less. Let us see this one. See, this we are discussing. Now let us see this one. This is conformations of the butane. Now let us, till now we discussed about the conformations of ethane and butane. Now let us go for the, another one is said to be the conformations of 1,2-dichloroethane. These are the different conformational isomers of the 1,2-dichloroethane. You can say this is going to be the, this is going to be the antiform. This is going to be the antiform. Why you can say, why you, can you say why it is? Because this, why it is antiform? Because the 2-chlorine, the bond angle is 180 degrees. That's why it is anti, what I mean to say, antiform. And by rotating here, you can get one eclipsed form. Again, you will get another staggered form. Again, 60 degrees, you'll get another here eclipsed form. You can see this structure. The 2-chlorine atoms are, what I meant to say, if we say this is a structure 1 and second structure, and you see this is going to be the third structure, and our another very important, and this is going to be the fourth structure. You can see this is a fourth structure. And this is going to be the fifth, and this is going to be the sixth form. And here what you can observe, the second form and fourth form and sixth forms are the eclipsed form. 1, 3, 5 are the staggered form. Let us see which is more stable in this case. Now here you get the same, which is more stable in this case. This is Gache form. And here it is a staggered form. Here also, why it is more stable? See, because this is antiform, just now we discussed. This is antiform. This is most stable and least energy because the chlorine, the larger sized chlorine atoms are far away from each other and they have separated by a law, that is separated by the maximum distance, that is 180 degrees angle. That's where repulsion is very less or minimum in this staggered configuration. Therefore, among the six, the fourth one, just now I told you, the fourth one is least stable, and the first one, that is antiform, is going to be the more stable. See this one. And here, this is the least stable. This is going to be the fourth form that we discussed. And this is the least stable, and it is said to be the syn form. This is going to be the anti form. This is going to be syn because the bond angle is zero between the similar groups. And this is the least stable one. This is the least stable one. This is going to be the more stable conformer in with respect to their torsional strain or potential energy. And this is going to be their energies differences between this one. And you can see this is going to be our antiform. This is going to be our antiform, which is more stable than compared to any other. And you can see this is the two chlorines are very close to each other, and there is a magma repulsion. That's why it is higher in energy. This is also the same. This is higher in energy. That's why this syn form is least stable, whereas this antiform is more stable. This is again in another way. There are only two forms here indicated. You can observe here, this is going to be the Gache form, and here it is going to be the syn antiform, which is more stable. And if you observe, this is here also, this is also stable, but this is the more stable, whereas this is the normal stable. These two are said to be the that is a staggered form, but in this form. Whereas here it is also staggered, but the bond angle between the two bonds of the chlorine is 180 degrees. And here this is the least stable one, that is going to be the syn form, eclipsed form, that is the fourth form that we discussed till now. See the rotational barriers of the remaining haloketones. This is 1,1 dichloroethane. This is trichloroethane. This is going to be the 1,2 dichloroethane. Just now we discussed here. This is hexachloroethane. Now let us see, these are the structures. You can see this is going to be the 1,1 dichloroethane, where it is 4.8. This is going to be the 4.8 kilojoules. So this is going to be the trichloroethane, where it is 6.1 kilojoules. And here it is, till now we discussed the 1,2 dichloroethane, where its potential energy is 10 kilocalories per mole, whereas the last one, hexachloroethane, has the 10.8 kilojoules of energy. Hexachloroethane has a barrier only about 20% higher than the 1,2 dichloroethane. 0.03 angstrom increases in the carbon-carbon bond length, about 2% hexachloroethane, caused by the extensive dipole repulsion. Now let us discussed about the 1,2 dichloroethane, the last in this one, 2-chloroethanol. This is the last molecule that we're going to discuss in this session. This is going to be the 2-chloroethanol. This is the chlorine, second carbon, and first carbon is OH, and this is going to be this one. And here, this is going to be the anti-form, where OH and Cl bond angle is, what I mean to say, that is 180 degrees. Then it is going to be the anti-form. You can see this one. This is 2-chloroethanol. Now let us see the different forms. We'll discuss only two forms. One is said to be the antiform, another is the dipole. Here actually, in previous discussion, we observed that antiforms or anti-staggered forms are more stable. But in this particular case, because of the dipole attraction, that is, you can say a hydrogen bond rises between the chlorine and the hydrogen when this is in this structure. And OH and chlorine, when come to the closure, that is going to be, this is another eclipse staggered form only. And in this case, what happens? This is the more stable conformer when compared to this anti-form. That means in most of the cases, the anti or staggered forms are more stable. In few cases where this type of interactions are rises, in such cases, that is said to be the more stable. Okay, this is going to be the more stable 2-chloroethanol. And with this, we can conclude our session. In this session, we discussed about the what is meant by conformation analysis and what are the terms involved, what are their meaning, like antiform, Gauche form, skew form, like that. We discussed many things. And also, what are the different conformations and their energy barriers of conformations of conformers of ethane, butane, 1,2-dichloroethane, finally 2-chloroethanol. With this, we can conclude this session. In the next session, we are going to discuss about the conformational analysis of the cyclohexane, as well as the the Bayer strain theory in cycloalkanes. Thank you, and one and all. I hope this you are clearly understood regarding this one. And if it is useful, then you share it and subscribe my channel. Thank you.